Hello everybody, this is Anna, also known as Ananita on Ravelry, Ananita on Facebook, but with a blank, and on Instagram you can find me as Annalena Nita. This is a knitting podcast. I never mentioned it before, I guess, in the introduction, so this is about knitting and all the lovely crafting stuff. And yes, I'm totally off schedule. It's Tuesday, and normally I podcast Wednesday or Thursday. But I didn't knit that much the past week or the past 10 days or so. And I wanted to wait and collect some things for you to show to make it more interesting. Okay, first things first, we have a year-long knit-along. It's the blanket along. You can sew, crochet, knit, or whatever you like to do. But it has to be a blanket. You don't have to finish the blanket to be able to win a prize. But you should be a member of the Ravelry group, our podcast group. You can find the group on Ravelry by typing in Ananita or Ananita podcast. But the next time, it's May 1st, I will draw the winner from the Instagram feed. It's the hashtag Ananita blanket along. Yes. So the next time, May 1st, make sure you post one or two or I don't know how many pictures you want with a hashtag on Instagram, Ananita blanket along, and I will draw the winner from Instagram. The next time, 1 or 2 months after May 1st, it will be Ravelry again. And so I will alternate through the whole year of 2017. The prizes you can actually win, you can find in the first post in our Ravelry group in the specific thread for it. It's the blanket along thread, or it's called blanket along, I guess, or Ananita blanket along, but I sticked it on top so you can easily find it. Okay, just in case you forget what I was doing for our along, I don't know if I did a progress since last time. I really don't know. I'm so sorry. It was so busy the last 2 weeks. But that's my crochet blanket. It's not my only blanket, but that's the blanket I do enjoy the most. I don't know. I did put a progress keeper here, so it could be... No. I guess it was from last time. I only attached this one, and I guess I already showed it. But just in case you're interested, that's my granny stripe crochet blanket. If you want to see it in whole, is it correct? It's my whole arm span. Okay, wait, we got that. Okay, okay, that's it. You can see it. It's very stretchy, but it's about 130. I hope it wasn't... I hope you could hear it, what I was saying. Now I say it again. It's about 130 centimeters wide, but I didn't measure it for a throw over the sofa or the bed. It's just, after finishing this, it will always lay on my sofa for the evenings when I cuddle up and watching Netflix or knit, just to keep me warm. I do have a throw over my bed, and what these things, related these things, I'm very OCD like. It has to be asymmetric, you know what I mean, and it has to go with the colors of my room, and this is too crazy for me to throw it over my bed to cover the whole bed, because it's screaming, hey, it's not in the right order and there are so many colors, and oh no. I wouldn't stand it. Okay, that's my blanket. Now I want to show you my whips, but let me take a Austrian drink. It's Red Bull, or do you say Ball? No, that sounds weird. Bull. Do you say bull, like bullseye? Red Bull. It's the sugar-free version. Oh my gosh, it's so delicious. And it helps me to keep concentrated. In the evenings, when I really want to stay up, the sugar-free version doesn't keep me awake. Also, the sugar version, not really. I don't know. I'm so... Oh, now we get to words I don't know again. In German, it's the Blutdruck. You know, the thing you measure here with the... Read the screen, please. And my mine is always very low. So I, when I'm doing exercises, for example, in the gym, when I'm riding the bike or whatever, it takes a long, long time to get a high, read the screen, Blutdruck. Blood pressure? I can't imagine that you call it blood pressure, because that would be word by word translation, and that's nearly never the case. Okay. And that's the reason why these things like coffee or black tea, strong black tea, don't really keep me awake or awake me or refresh me like other ones. I really need a double espresso to feel the impact of the caffeine. But everything below espresso doesn't do a lot to me. So yes, it's good and it's bad at the same time. I think I won't get heart problems easily, because even when I'm angry, my blood pressure is low, you know. Okay, my whips. Let's go over to whips. As I said, I didn't knit a lot the past few days or the past week. But these two projects I put a dent on. It's the Among the Shadows Shawl by Killeen Kinnersley, I hope. Yes, it's Killeen Kinnersley. I will show it scrunched up on the needles. And now I will take it apart a bit to let you show, to let you see this. You see the progress keeper where I stopped, where I showed you the last time. And this is what I could have been done already with this, because it's DK weight and 5mm needle. I had it the last time already. 4.5 or 5mm needles. So it goes very quick and it's not a complicated pattern. You start with the garter stitch only, then you do the garter ridges, alternating stockinette and garter, and then finishing with a 2x2 ribbing, how long you want it. I don't know, I still have plenty left. I didn't weigh it, but I guess I should just use everything up, because what do I do with the leftover DK weight yarn? I don't know. Do you have any suggestions? It's the colorway Serve the Servants by A Homespun House by Molly. And it's the same blend as the soft sock base, but it's in DK. And I love this colorway. And I didn't alternate the skeins. And I started the second, the lighter one, somewhere over here, and I think you can't really see it. And I would love to make a cardigan out of this. I mean, look how pretty it is. I didn't do this before. Normally when I knit something, I often go to the mirror and look how it... Oh, Liz is writing. Liz, if you see this, it's Rubby Tats, I guess it's called, pronounced, on Instagram, and I just the message popped up. She wrote me. I asked her what her Ravelry name is, and I wasn't able to read it now. I will talk about her later. Hey Liz. Okay, normally I go often to the mirror and look how it goes with my skin, and oh my gosh, I love this. Molly, you did such a great job. Molly, please dye more, and maybe in fingering weight, maybe I can ask her. I want to knit a cardigan or something. It's the wrong way, I know. Normally, I will wear the shawl that way, but it's on the needles, it always shapes the wrong direction. Oh, I love these colors. As when I saw them, when I saw this yarn on her page, I immediately ordered it. I didn't know what I was going to knit out of this because it's DK weight and I'm not very used to DK. When I see a pair of, fingering weight balls of yarn, I always know, okay, three of them would make a long featherweight cardigan or 2.5. One is a shawlette or a pair of socks or a hat. I always have possibilities in mind when I see fingering weight yarn, but I don't really know how much I need to make out of DK. I guess one would have made a hat, but I don't know how many would be left after finishing a hat and so on. So I still have to experience more knitting with DK weight, but I do enjoy it. In the beginning, it was exhausting for my hands because these needles are very thick in comparison compared to what I normally use. But it's okay. I love it. And it's quick. And oh my gosh, this color. Okay, I show it one more time and then away. It's totally scrunched up because I always use short cords so that I don't have to rearrange all the time. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. And in this shawl, you see how it looks in stockinette and in garter and in the ribbing. That's always interesting for me when I use variegated or self-strapping yarn and how it looks in the different patterns. I'm sorry, my nose. It's always when I'm showing off fiber-related stuff. that's the one. And I need another sip. No, I put it here. In the commercial, they always say Red Bull verleiht Flügel, and in English it would be Red Bull gives you wings. And it's true. Yesterday in the late evening, I drank one of this, one bottle or one this material, you know. And normally I can't concentrate in the evenings on writing my thesis or reading more complicated or intense books. But then I said to myself, you want to write right now? And it was, I don't know, 9 o'clock or so. It's in the evening and it's so untypical for me. And I wrote, I think, 3 pages of my thesis. Okay, the next and last work in progress is the Georgetown Cardigan by Hannah Fettig, made out of cashmere tweed by Shulana. And I guess on this I made plenty of progress. Or did I? Why did I? Oh yes, I know. That's not the progress keeper. That's the to keep track of the increases. Yes. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. okay. No, here's the progress keeper. So I did this whole section. I show it first this way. It's the back. But I show you it. I can't show you laying it on my back. Okay. I think I will be... It won't take long till I have to do the shoulders. Now I show it in detail. It's a bit airy because I had to use 4.5 or 4 millimeter needles to get gauge. Yes, it's very easy. And this yarn is very forgiving because it's spun uneven. So How can I show? I think I showed you the last time. It's not like the pregnant worms, like you say in spinning, but it's very irregular spun. There you can see it. And so it's very forgiving if you change your tension during knitting or yes, make mistakes. I like it. But it's a winter or autumn cardigan. And now, as you can see, I'm wearing my dress. It's very warm today. It's very springy. Yesterday was the beginning of spring. And if some people from Iran are watching, Happy New Year. Yesterday you had Nowruz. And I think you celebrated for over 10 days or so. And that's cool. Yes, these were my works in progress. Oh, the lightning is changing. I'm very sorry. I don't know how you can see it now. And now I want to go over to some... I'm looking there because it's like Christmas what I see there. I received two parcels. The first I will show you is from Natasha. She's the one who is donating the pillow for the blanket along, and just randomly she shipped this parcel to me just because she's nice and generous, and I want to show you what she sent me. One thing I already ate up. I was keeping one to show you, but no, they were too delicious. She sent me a full package of macaroons, but I think two types of dishes are called macaroons, and these she sent me were little coconut tarts. Oh my gosh, they are so delicious. I have to look for them where I can get them. So delicious. Natasha, the best thing I have ever ate. Really. Sweet wise. So, now I will unwrap it the first time because she sent me some fabric and I wanted to keep it nice wrapped. Oh, I love those colors. Oh, I think now it's very... I have to wait a bit. I think it's better now. You can see better. So, this way. Okay, these are totally my colors. Natural brown and blue. And then this. And that's cool because when I was a child, I loved Winnie the Pooh. I loved him, and I loved in German he is called Ferkel, Piglet. So cute. The next I think it's my favorite fabric. No, my two favorites are in here. The first I have printed, we say terrier, I think it's terrier also in English, yes. Terriers. It's not the breed. Yes, Benny is, because this is the one who is in the Walt Disney film Lady and Tramp. The black one is, you know him, the old dog who fell in love with Susie. And it's so cute. I was thinking about sewing a neckwear for Benny out of this, because he has one in red, but I have to wash it sometimes, clearly. And I think that would be so cute. Tiny little dogs. Or maybe I can sew a toy out of this or so. But he's very rude to toys, maybe not. This is great. I would love to have a dress out of this fabric. Red, very classy or preppy, or yes. And that's the second favorite. I love this because it's so North Sea, the cabins, or how here this it's called, beach huts. It's cool. Thank you, Natasha. It's so cool. That's not all. As I said, the delicious macaroons were in this. It was such a big, I think 5 or 6 big macaroons were in there. Oh my gosh, so delicious. I wasn't able to stop. I knew they are very sweet and a lot of calories and so on. And normally I don't want to overdo it with these things, but I couldn't stop. They were so good. Then she sent me this very expensive looking tea. It's lavender and in German we pronounce it Echinacea. I don't know how you pronounce it. But that's very good because the second flower is helping very much when I'm ill, you know, when you have all the words today. Grippe. In German we say Grippe. Read the screen. Twinings, winter spice. It's always good. Spicy is always good. A bag of snore and peace herbal tea. A good night tea, so to say. And that one is delicious. Chamomile? I don't know how you pronounce it. Vanilla and manuka honey. From Puka. Very good, very good. And then, it's so cute. Okay, the first one. As I also have, she has a problem. I'm sorry, the cranking. She has a problem with winding minis. And I think it's a very hard job also. So she wound one mini in a skein. And she wrote, okay, I tried it and it looks horrible, she says. But it's very good because it's not loose. Mine is always loose and always ends hanging out somewhere. And she says, sorry. And as I wrote her, it's for me totally fine if she just winds it into balls because then I can knit it right away. They look cute in your bowl, but you always have to wind the balls from them and I hate it. I want to start right away when I decide to knit on my Stitch and Time blanket. And that's so cute because she wound the balls and then put ribbons on them. It's a rainbow. And that's a wine and deep red. It looks more orange on here, but it's more wine red. Very pretty. And she wrote it on this cute cardigan, as I showed you last time. So cool. Thank you, Natasha. Very, very cool. I always love those things. Oh, and I already ate the Puffreis. I don't know the English word. Read the screen again. It's the episode of the screen reading. So, now we come to a totally unexpected, totally overwhelming, generous, unbelievable, stunning, good taste, fill in some more words here, package from Liz. And Liz is, I wrote it down, Rabbitatz. Yeah, it sounds like a Pokemon. Rabbitatz on Instagram. Maybe I can write the Ravelry name here on the screen. I think she answered already. She asked me if she could send me something and I said yes, totally, for cool. And she took some photos, two photos, and sent me on Instagram and showed I'm gathering things for you. But I wasn't expecting that much. And when I opened the big parcel, it was such a big parcel, and I saw it's from the US and it's so big, and I thought, no, that can't be from Rabbitatz, from Liz, that can't be possible. But it was from her, and it's always the same. I had a very, very bad day and I was very sad, and then I opened the door and saw, oh my god, the postman left something for me. And my legs were soft, like we say Wackelpudding. It's a special kind of pudding or pudding. I can show you a picture here. It's very glibbery and shaky. It's delicious. What we say when we are excited or nervous, or if we are in fear of something, we have legs like this pudding. So and I was opening it and unwrapping step by step, and my legs were like this, and I was speechless and always said, I can't believe it. I was alone, but I talked to myself sometimes. And I always said to myself, I can't believe it. That can't be true. It must be a mistake. That can't be for me. I can't believe it because I'm not used to these, I don't know, generous things. It's really stunning. It was because we didn't knew each other before. She is just watching my podcasts and wrote me and asked me if she could send me something. And it's so, maybe it's because I'm living in Austria and I am from Germany, because it's not typical for Austrians or for Germans to send a totally foreign person what I will show you now. I'm so grateful. And I, especially because as a student, I can't spend very much money on my hobby things. And oh my gosh, when I see... Okay, I stopped talking now. I have to show it. As I said, I'm speechless. Okay. Yes, I don't know if I should show it in... No, I will show it after, step by step. Okay. She sent me a lot of yarns from Republic of Wool. And I never had Republic of Wool because it's, again, Indidaya and US and not easy to get here. And I heard of this brand, I guess, from Sarah, from the Love Sock Cool podcast. And from this colorway. And it goes so perfect with the dress and with so many things I have in my cupboard. These colors are so springy and happy and girly, and oh, they make me so happy. I don't know what to knit out of this. Maybe a shawl? I don't know. I really don't know. Maybe you can suggest me some things for DK weight yarn, because I have no clue, really. I only know I have to knit it, I don't know, yesterday. It's perfect. It's so perfect. I'm happy. The next also is perfect. I'm thinking about making a hat, but I don't know if it looks good on me. This is so perfect. Oh, I'm sorry, the colorway names. This is Mermaid Bait. And this is Aftermath. So cool. It's gray and then these speckles of teal, blue and magenta. I love it. I love it. I mean, that would have been more than enough. But it goes on and on and on. Then she sent me this set of pre-cut fabrics. Oh my gosh. I don't show you I think it's every piece is another one. It's difficult, I'm sorry. Oh, this is so... I love those feminine girly things. Oh, cute. Like a dollhouse thing. I don't know, it's Penny Rose Fabrics. I don't know this brand because it's foreign. Then another set and even more fabric in here is T42 by Deb Grogan. And here it stands. 10 inches squares and 42 pieces. And everything has to do with tea. No, it's like, yes, you have some with cups of teas and pots and then roses. Oh, tea bags with the different tea, with the different teas on the tags. So cute. Strawberries. Oh my gosh. I would love to learn the quilt as you go method, because I think in the other way I wouldn't be able to quilt on my own. I only would be able to quilt the top, to sew the top and then to give it to my local fabric store. Everything was very nice wrapped in. I kept it, for example, with these pompons and this tag. Oh, I love those things, really, I do. And this paper is so cool with the crowns. And again, a tag, and on the tag stands, for you. It's so... I won't show you her note, but I will show the card, because the card also is very pretty. It says, those who touch our lives with kindness add beauty to our days. Oh, thank you. And now I can't show you. Because, oh, Natasha's card. I forgot Natasha's card, because her card is also so cool, because it's a heart queen or queen heart, you know, from the cards. And it reminded me of Alice in Wonderland. Okay, I always receive messages on my iPad. And now it's crazy. There's still so much left. And these pretty boxes and so on, you know. Everything is so pretty. Okay, I will start with the small one. Oh, I wanted to show you the... Oh yes, there it is. That's funny. In one of the boxes was a toy for Benny. And I hear him now. And the day after the package arrived, yes, the day after, I think, yes, I had to go to the doctor with him because he needed to read the screen. I forgot the word. So he wasn't ill, but he needed to get the injection. You know, you read the screen. And it's the last time he was, okay, he was much smaller, but it hurts him and he was angry. No, not angry, he was in fear and nervous, and after that he only wanted to sleep. And so I thought I will keep this toy for after the doctor to... Sorry, I was interrupted because my... Oh, I'm looking to the wrong side now. Because my memory was full. And I had to take Benny with me. I was going to say that Robbie Tats also gifted me something for Benny. And it already looks like this humble thing here. It looked so pretty when I gave it to him. He loves it. And he plays a lot with it. Here also the... No, it's not the stuffing. Okay. And I will show you something. Benny, come. Da, come here. Here. Sit. High five. Nein. High five. Benny, high five. I'm sorry. High five. Yeah, high five. Nein. Das ist Pfötchen. Das ist Pfötchen. Benny. High five. Yay. Gib Fuß? Ja. Du bist so ein Süßer. Ein Süßer. Okay, and now look, Benny, here. And he always says to bring it to me or to play with it. I don't know. It's just look. Benny. Benny. Ooh, ooh. And I hope he will play with it now a bit, because sometimes he comes to me and brings it to me so that I have to throw it away again and so on and so on. But I wanted to show you the last things, and I think I have to be very quick now. Do you hear? Sometimes it makes this ee-ee-ee. I wasn't able to make it ee-ee-ee because maybe you need sharp dog tooth. Okay, he wants me to throw it again. It's so funny. It's the first time that he freiwillig, on his own, bring something back to me so that I can throw it again. It's the first toy he makes it with. Okay, this package. I start with the smaller one. And in this was the toy for Benny. And I gave it to him. I don't know where the last section stopped, but I gave it to him after going to the doctor's with him, because he needed to get read the screen, please. Okay, this section is a bit more hectic because I have to play with the dog a bit. Okay, she added these delicious chocolates and then mini eggs. Oh my gosh. I love chocolate and everything. And this is so pretty and I think very delicious. It is hot cinnamon sunset black tea with cinnamons, orange and sweet cloves. And it's polka dot inside. Sugar paper from Los Angeles. So pretty. So pretty. These boxes alone are also, I guess, very expensive. So pretty. And then the I'm sorry. It was the lamp. The second box. Maybe I can light it up a bit. It's bigger. Wee. Again, with this crown paper. Crinkling alert. Okay, on top is a gift or a prize for you all. It looks so cool. I have never knit with something like this, but I can't knit with it because it has alpaca in it. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot the wool inside. It's knit collage, I guess. And it's 75% wool and 25% mohair, and it's itchy on my skin, and it has this you know, this and flowers and this glitter garlands, and it's so cool. And I think these are two. Yeah, soft. But always when I knit with this, I'm allergic, I'm sorry. And it's so cool. And she said to me that I can pick something as a prize for you. I have never seen this before. It's so cool. I think it would make a very crazy and cool hat. Okay, this is a prize for our blanket along. Soll ich es nochmal werfen? Oh nein, den Spitzer gesehen da. Sorry, I'm talking with Benny and he can't understand English. And I mean, seriously, it's Benny. Hi.
Hey, my baby. Du bist ein Baby.
He is already 8 months, but he's still a baby for me. Okay, and the last... the colors. I'm sorry, the colors. The three of a kind. And the colorway name. I'm sorry, it's a lot of crinkling, but I wanted to show you how I received it. Swiss Miss. How cool is that? 250 yards, 150 gram. and three of these. And please help me. What can I do with three skeins of DK weight? It's so cool. I'm sorry, it's so cool. This is more greenish than blue. On the screen it looks a bit more like blue, but it's more greenish or teal or how you say it. And it's soft and it's pretty, and I mean, seriously, it's unbelievable. I will take all the different colors. It makes me so happy, and I had such a bad... I'm sorry, but that's so perfect. I had such a bad day, and when I opened this package, I was speechless. Just speechless. Now what I will do is... I will do this. Because it looks gorgeous altogether. A whole package of yarn for me. And now I love DK, you know, because I have never knit with DK before, or not never, but not with indie dyed DK. So pretty. I'm so speechless. I'm honest. I'm so grateful, and it was so... Liz, you are awesome. You are very awesome. And I want to send you something when I'm back from Germany. I will gather something for you. Maybe I can get something from Germany for you. Because in a few days, I will head out to Germany. I will first visit my parents for a few days. And then I have to attend a PhD student seminar. I don't know, I think you would call it this way. It's a seminar only for the students who writing their thesis or the next step, and I don't know how to call it in... I don't know if you really make a difference between... You know, we have PhD and then the thing after PhD, but you can't really compare PhD and the doctor degree, so to say. It's a bit different because I think you can already teach with PhD and on a high school, not high school, I'm sorry, on a college. And here in Austria and Germany, you normally don't teach as a PhD. You have to do the next step. In Germany, it's Habilitation, and I don't know how you call it. Maybe it stands on the screen right now. And yes, it's a gathering of all the students who do the PhD or the next degree for the one professor. I don't know how to pronounce it. Yes, and we have to show off our progress and yes, all that stuff. And that's in Germany, and I have to attend it. And afterwards, I will come back and celebrate Easter here in Austria, and I'm looking forward to Easter. Oh my gosh. Because the liturgy on the 3 days, the Triduum, so it means the Thursday, Good Friday, and the Easter night. These 3 days are one liturgy. It doesn't end on Thursday or Friday. It's, you know, you normally the Holy Mass and starts with the sign of a cross and ends with a blessing by the priest. But to explain, the Mass or the liturgies on Thursday and Friday don't end with a blessing and go in peace, we say in German. Huh. I really don't know the liturgical terms in English. Yes, because it's one big mystery and one big liturgy, and I love it so much. I love every single song I love everything of the Easter liturgy, and especially the Easter night. I'm so looking forward to it. And especially I'm looking forward to the hymn the priest sings for the Easter candle. I love this so much. I'm thinking about... No, I can't say it in English. I'm sorry. Maybe I can put afterwards a few segments of the liturgies I usually attend. I usually was going or was attending where I studied. But this time I will celebrate Easter in Vienna. And I'm... Oh, I'm sorry, earthquake. And I'm very curious how it is because I'm a bit geeky or I'm a bit... Yes, my standard on regarding liturgy is very high. I'm disappointed very, very soon or very quick. I need... Yes, it has to be perfect. I'm very sorry. Normally, I only measure the OCD on myself, but with liturgy, I'm so strict. There's so much I really have to have in the Easter night or in the or in Christmas or so. You know? Yes, sometimes I'm not a very enjoyable companion. To go to Mass with because yes, I need incense and I need a priest who can sing, who can actually sing. If he can't sing, why he became a priest? I'm sorry, you need a good singing priest. And the vestments of the priest have to be not modern with this Batik look and that stuff. It has to be classic, traditional, and pretty and preppy. And yes, I mean. You know, it's liturgy and normally you should only use the best for liturgy. Even myself, I mean, my parents, I grew up with a very faithful family and we learned that there is dressing or clothes for the week and then for the Sundays. And when I was a child, there were some jackets or trousers or pullovers I only was allowed to wear on Sundays just to keep something special, the best clothes for the Sunday, for the day of God of Christ. And I think a priest and all the people who are doing the liturgy should even more focus on that. I don't like this modern stuff. I'm sorry. Yeah, okay, but I don't want to digress now. I think, let me take a look. Now he fell asleep. I can't believe it. I thought I have to go for a walk with him now, but maybe when I'm tidying up and he hears the crinkling, he wants to get out. I don't know. I try to get this episode out to you today so that I can edit it today and load it up today. I hope so. Last time there was a problem and I wanted to load it up in the night, but it stopped by 30% or so and they had to restart it the next day. So I was a day overdue, is it correct? Or delayed? But this time it doesn't really matter because I'm so off schedule now. Yes, and I don't know, maybe I will pause podcasting for 2 weeks because of preparing the seminar and then traveling Germany and so on. And yes, I hope I can squeeze in. Yes, I hope so. I can squeeze in right after coming back. Yeah. Oh, or maybe I can film in Germany. Oh, this I will try to film some segments in Germany at my parents' house where I grew up and show you. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, I will do this. I promise. I will do some vlogs or I will film a few segments and then put all together in an episode, and maybe I can knit and podcast in my childhood room where I lived, where I grew up, so you can see my roots, where I come from and what I'm talking about all the time. Okay, that's a cool idea. I will collect some ideas from what I want to show you. I think I want to show you our sea, the pond, and our black and white cows, and my favorite Italian cafe. Oh yes, and I will go to the yarn shop and buy some Oldenburg yarn. So it's the same you can get here, but it's... Then I bought it in Germany, you know. Oh, and I will go... Hey, yes. Oh, I have some ideas now. Oh, I have to write them all down now. I don't want to forget them. So I will stop here, you guys. I'm sorry if that this episode was a bit hectic or stressy. I'm very sorry. I will do my best the next time. And the next time we see each other from Germany. So, happy knitting. Bye-bye.